to Analytics with Nags. In this video, we're going to check about pie chart in Visuals with Nags series. If you're new to this channel, hit the subscribe button and press the bell icon for notification. Let's begin our today's topic. So when to use it? It is used to provide a contribution of different values to a total. In other words, we can say when you're trying to compare parts of a whole. So both points are similar meaning like you have a different categorical values and you want to analyze the total by each categorical value, how much it has contributed to the total. So that is what it is. And it is not meant for the changes over time. It is not useful when you have a time-based analysis. You cannot use this visual. Mostly it's for categorical distribution analysis. Mostly in my videos, I will say when to use it, but this particular visual is special, like where you should also know when not to use it. So we will check it out in the demo. Let's jump into demo. We are in Power BI. Let me explain the model first. So it's a typical adventure works. I have fact table, it is connected to territory, and I have a snowflake dimension here, where it is directly related to product and product subcategory and category. So when you apply filter here, it will propagate here, and from this table it will propagate here, and that in turn filters the fact table. So this is the simple model. Now let's jump into our demo. We will have our pie chart over here, and let me drag and zoom it out. I want to analyze the order quantity, so when I click on it, it will go here. Now I will use the product English category name. So let me increase the some of the properties here, detail label. Let me increase the size, and now I will increase the legend as well. So legend is this one, and this is the detail label. Now as we discussed earlier, it is used to give you the contribution of this category against the total. The total quantity is around 60k, and for that 60k, it has splitted, right? This accessories contributed 59%. That is the contribution it has brought. This is the biggest contributor of the sales quantity, and followed by bikes and clothing. So when you can use it, when you want to see the distribution and you have very less quantities, I mean to say less categorical values, I can say maximum it should be 5 categories, and you can go for pie chart. If it is exceeding more than 5, pie chart is not your choice. So this is about pie chart, and I'm going to demonstrate when you should not use it. The same pie chart, I will have it here, okay, and I will use the order quantity. This time, instead of products category, I will use product subcategory. This time you can see I will use the same formatting behavior here. As you can see here, in this product subcategory, this chart is not so effective. You can see the distribution is between the smaller proportion, whichever is contributed. It doesn't look good, and we cannot able to analyze much better. So this is where the problem comes. So when you have a more categorical values, you should not go for the pie chart. And also this chart will ignore some of the least contributed item sometimes in some cases. Like you see here, this is contributed 28%, and this particular value, like the bike stands, it has contributed very less. Sometimes this will not be visible at all. So this chart is not useful when you have more categorical values. So how usually we need to manage is like we need to create a hierarchy. This in turn contains hierarchy. You can keep the categorical name first, okay, then in turn you can go inside. Now from accessories, when you drill down, you filter down somewhat. So this is somewhat better than directly accessing the subcategory, right? So when you click from here, it will be further. It was very decent now. Okay, when you click on bikes, you can see here, right? So this is how you can manage that. Instead of directly accessing or analyzing using subcategory, you need to go for it. This is kind of a workaround, and you can make use of the hierarchies as well. So these are some of the issues I want to highlight. Like if you have more categorical values, you cannot use the pie chart. And then if one category has 90% contribution and other has very less contribution, 1%, 2%, you should not go for it, because the least contributor will not be shown at all sometimes. So that is the another issue you will face. I hope you understand about this pie chart. And other properties I want to highlight. One important property here is like detail label. Here you can mention different options over here, whether you want to only show the I will delete this one, it is not required. So whether you want to show only the category, or you want to show along with category and data value. So data value means this one, right? I mean whatever value contributes, or data value and percentage of total. So as already it has a color here, so you can use this format. This will be perfect choice by default choice as well. Otherwise you can choose all details. So one important tip here is like when you use all values here, all details, do not use the labels. That will save your space, because already you have a color wise color, then you should not use this one. This is the point I want to make. So in this case, if you choose it, make it as legend half. So at a point I want to highlight is like there is a similar property. Everything remains same for a donut chart, the pie chart and donut chart. The only thing it differs is like it will having a hole at the center. That is what. So it will be like slices here, where it will be like in the donut you have different pieces. So that is the only difference. So you can interchangeably use a pie chart or donut chart, whichever suits for it. Even all other properties remain same. I hope some of the tips, tricks, and when to use it, when not to use it, you aware of now with respect to pie chart. If you like this video, hit the thumbs up button and comment below for queries. And do remember that data is your asset.